But a moment's sunlight fading in the grass. This track is so haunting. This is one of my all-time favorite recordings, guys. Oh my God. Okay, so talk about a period piece, a record that defines an entire era. 1967, Youngblood's Get Together. Okay, so, you know, I did a little bit of crawling down the rabbit hole with this song. I always knew it was a cover. It said on Wikipedia that it was written by a guy named Chet Powers, who had a stage name Dino Valenti, who I think he was from the band Quicksilver Messenger Service. This song's been recorded by a million people. Kingston Trio, David Crosby, Staple Singers, Carpenters, Johnny Cash, Dave Clark Five. But this version of it is, you know, absolutely the most well-known, and for a very good reason. This thing, I can't tell you how much this record just blows my mind. It always has. I love when a record is just like a world. When you turn it on and you hit play, it just transports you somewhere. The sound of this record, it's just fucking unbelievable. I've always been amazed by it. Okay, so, I mean, this, you know, I don't really know how to play this. I mean, there's so many guitars going on in here, and they're all amazing. 12-string madness going on. But, like, look, this opening riff, okay? Check it out, how weird this is. The stretch. Okay, so what I've learned about classic records in trying to dissect them all these years is that if something is too hard to play that you learned off a classic record by ear, it's probably wrong, right? Because these guys, they weren't into playing like complicated things, you know. And usually you'll find out that if you learn it the right way, it's pretty easy to play because that's how they wrote it. But this riff, I mean, I have thought about this. There is no other way to play this riff, to capo the guitar or anything that makes it any more easy than this. You got the half-step rub that Buki loves, you know? D, F sharp, and G. And I know it's not capoed. I can tell by listening to all the other voicings that he's doing. He plays a lot of open add nines. So in the verse, you know, it's like, you know, do me come, so me go. And it goes down to a G. And then there's all this amazing guitar riffing that happens, you know. Where he's playing out of the G major scale. Using that C natural note, which is a pretty strong flavor in this A. So I think in a later, a more modern recording, you know, people might tend to suss that sharp 11 on that, you know, on that G chord. You know, staying more in the original key. But they didn't. They were like, shamelessly. working out of that G major scale, which is great, right? That's what gives it that haunting quality, man. It's like, so then the chorus, you know, D, four chord, five chord, one, four, five. Okay, so funny story. I was driving my boys to school this morning, like I drive them every morning, right? They're 6 and 9 now. And they're little musicologists because I've told you guys, I have grilled them, played them classic music every morning of their lives since they were little embryos, you know. So today was like Summer of Love Day. I gave them Turn, Turn, Turn by the Birds, and then I played this track. And man, by the time both of those songs were over, I looked back in the back seat and they were both just like in the daze, so chilled out. And I said to Leo, the young one, I said, man, what do you think of that song? And he goes, I don't really like that song, but I do like the part where it says booger. And I'm like, what? What are you talking about? And then I listened to the chorus. Come on, people now, smile on. I swear to God, it literally sounds like they're saying booger instead of brother. Listen to it. It's amazing. So I'll never think of that song the same way again, but man, that kid's got an ear. I'm telling you. And we were dying laughing in the car. Oh my God. I don't think I've ever laughed that hard when I realized that he's right. It does sound like he's saying booger. Anyway, let's move on. There's a killer drum and bass breakdown that happens. Okay, the thing is tiered beautifully. Like, aside from the amazing vocal performance and the incredible lyrics, the thing's got a cool structure. First time it's one chorus, then it goes to two choruses. And by the end, they do three choruses in a row, really driving home that love your brother point, right? Great arrangement, four and a half minutes long. In the middle, dig this drum and bass breakdown. It's pretty rad. Here it comes. Killer solo. Getting a little Indian there. Nice breakdown right here. I love this. Hell yeah. Now dig these chords that he gets into. Playing up real high, look. Right here. If you hear the song I sing, you will understand. Listen, like on Spinal Tap. Listen to what the flower people say. He's up high playing this add 9 up here. And then when it goes down to the G, he makes it a G6 by doing an E minor voicing over this bass note. Which you know Uncle Larry likes that shit, right? And then when you're playing this type of music, you got to do the old Beatle voicing where you play your D chords like this and your E, right? You know, like the Beatles did, like a C chord capoed up. No idea who played this shit. I looked it up. It said the band was like Jesse Colin Young on vocals and guitar. There was two other guitar players, Jerry Corbett and Lowell Levenger. I don't know who played what. It's killer. It's a great choir of guitars. Anyway, Enough about that. I think I made my point evidently clear that I love that record. Okay, so now on to shameless self-promotion. Today I'll be sending a box of CDs to Drew at Guitar House. So the Plexi Soul record will be available on CD. I'm gonna order a whole nother box of 250 more. I got a good feeling that we might need that. And more importantly, more exciting is the fact that we got two new t-shirts coming. Ryan Conover, our resident genius, came up with two killer ideas for a new t-shirt line. And those are going to be up real soon on the Guitar House, www.guitarhouse.net website. Okay, Guitar House of Tulsa. This guitar, I've had this forever. Duesenberg 12 string. The greatest 12 string a man can get. These things are unbelievable. I don't even know if they still make these, but these are amazing. I mean, the thing is, plays beautifully, tunes up beautifully. Sounds amazing. Guys, I think that's enough torture for today. Have a good day, and I'll talk to you real soon, okay? Patriots, Bills tonight should be a hell of a game. I'm super excited about that. I think I'm going to put a pile on the Patriots tonight. So tell me if I'm wrong. All right, guys.